Imagine a vast expanse of blue stretching as far as the eye can see. Now picture this. Amidst the sparkling waves, a massive island emerges, not made of sand or rock, but of trash. This is the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, a floating collection of debris trapped in a slow-moving vortex of ocean currents. It's not an island you could walk on, but a swirling soup of plastic and other waste, much of it hidden beneath the surface. It's a stark reminder of the impact human actions have on our planet, even in the remotest corners of our oceans. The Great Pacific Garbage Patch is just one of several garbage patches found in our oceans. These patches are formed by rotating ocean currents called gyres, which act like giant whirlpools, drawing in debris from coastlines and shipping lanes. Over time, this trash accumulates, creating a swirling mass of plastic and other waste. The North Pacific Gyre, where the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is located, is the largest of these gyres, spanning from California to Japan and nearly reaching the Hawaiian Islands. The journey of a plastic bottle from your recycling bin to the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is a long and winding one. It begins on land, where plastic waste is often improperly disposed of, finding its way into rivers and streams. These waterways act as conveyor belts, carrying the trash downstream towards the ocean. Once in the ocean, the plastic is caught in currents, both large and small, which transport it across vast distances. It's like a giant game of ocean currents, with plastic waste as the unwilling participant. The North Pacific Gyre, with its slow-moving currents, acts like a giant sink, trapping the plastic and other debris that flow into it. Over time, this debris accumulates, forming the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. The patch is not a solid mass of trash, as is often depicted, but more like a plastic soup, with larger items like fishing nets and buoys interspersed among countless smaller pieces of plastic. This plastic soup poses a significant threat to marine life, entangling animals, being mistaken for food, and leaching harmful chemicals into the water. The Great Pacific Garbage Patch is located in the North Pacific Gyre, a vast system of rotating ocean currents that stretches between North America and Asia. These currents are driven by wind patterns and the Earth's rotation, creating a circular flow that traps debris within its boundaries. Unlike the fast-moving currents we often see near coastlines, the currents within the gyre are relatively weak and sluggish, allowing trash and debris to accumulate over time. The location of the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is not static, but rather shifts and changes shape depending on wind and current patterns. It's like a giant, ever-evolving puzzle with pieces of plastic constantly moving and rearranging within the gyre. The patch is most densely concentrated in two areas, the Western Garbage Patch, located near Japan, and the Eastern Garbage Patch, located between Hawaii and California. The size of the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is difficult to determine precisely, as it's not a solid mass with clearly defined boundaries. However, scientists estimate that it covers an area of approximately 1.6 million square kilometers, which is twice the size of Texas and three times the size of France. To put it in perspective, imagine a landmass larger than the entire Amazon rainforest, covered in plastic waste. It's a sobering thought that highlights the sheer scale of plastic pollution in our oceans. The depth of the garbage patch also varies, with debris found from the surface down to hundreds of meters below. It's like a multi-layered cake of trash, with larger, more buoyant items floating near the top, and smaller, denser particles sinking further down. This makes cleanup efforts incredibly challenging, as removing the plastic requires specialized equipment and techniques to target different depths. While plastic bottles are often the poster child for ocean pollution, the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is actually a melting pot of debris, encompassing a wide range of materials. The majority, however, is plastic in various forms, from single-use plastic bags and water bottles to discarded fishing nets and industrial packaging. The patch really reflects our insatiable appetite for this durable yet problematic material. But it's not just consumer goods. The garbage patch contains debris from shipping, fishing, and industrial activities as well. One of the most insidious components of the garbage patch is microplastics. These tiny plastic fragments, less than 5 millimeters in size, are often invisible to the naked eye, but permeate the water column, posing a significant threat to marine life. Microplastics originate from larger plastic items that break down over time due to sunlight, waves, and marine life, and from microbeads found in personal care products. The Great Pacific Garbage Patch is, you know, a silent threat to marine life, impacting creatures of all shapes and sizes. For larger animals like whales, dolphins, and sea turtles, the patch is a navigation hazard, with discarded fishing nets and plastic debris posing serious entanglement risks. Just imagine a majestic humpback whale, entangled in a web of discarded fishing gear, struggling desperately to break free. These encounters can lead to injury, starvation, or even, sadly, death. Smaller animals such as fish and seabirds often mistake plastic pieces for food, which leads to ingestion and eventually starvation. They fill their stomachs with indigestible plastic, giving them a false sense of fullness and over time causing them to starve. Picture a seabird chick, its stomach filled with plastic bottle caps and cigarette lighters, mistaking these brightly colored objects for food. The plastic provides no nutritional value and can block their digestive tracts, making survival nearly impossible. But the impact doesn't stop with marine life. Beyond the immediate harm to ocean creatures, the Great Pacific Garbage Patch also poses risks to humans. The plastic in the patch can absorb harmful pollutants from the surrounding water, acting like sponges for toxins. These contaminated plastic pieces can then enter the food chain when ingested by marine animals, potentially reaching our plates and posing health risks to us as well. The impact of the Great Pacific Garbage Patch on marine life is not just a hypothetical concern, it's actually a stark reality playing out in our oceans every single day. One heartbreaking example is the plight of albatrosses, those large seabirds that forage for food over vast distances. Albatrosses are particularly vulnerable to plastic ingestion, since they often mistake floating plastic debris for squid or other prey. Studies have shown that albatross chicks are dying from starvation and dehydration, their stomachs filled with plastic debris fed to them by their parents. Sea turtles, ancient mariners that have roamed the oceans for millions of years, are also facing an uphill battle against plastic pollution. These gentle creatures often mistake plastic bags for jellyfish, which are a staple in their diet. Ingesting plastic can block their digestive tracts, leading to starvation or internal injuries. The sight of a sea turtle struggling to survive with a plastic straw lodged in its nostril is honestly a stark reminder of the devastating impact of our plastic addiction. These are just a few examples of the countless stories of marine animals suffering the consequences of plastic pollution. From microscopic plankton to massive whales, no creature is immune to the pervasive reach of this man-made problem. Addressing the Great Pacific Garbage Patch requires, well, a multi-pronged approach, tackling both the source of the pollution and the debris already accumulating in the gyre. Numerous organizations and individuals around the world are dedicated to this challenging task, working tirelessly to clean up our oceans and prevent further plastic waste from entering the environment. One such organization is the Ocean Cleanup, a nonprofit developing and deploying advanced technologies to remove plastic from the oceans. Their innovative systems, such as the so-called System 002, act like giant artificial coastlines, passively collecting plastic using the ocean's natural currents. Alongside these large-scale cleanup efforts, countless individuals and community groups are making a difference through beach cleanups, educational campaigns, and advocacy for plastic reduction policies. Every piece of plastic removed from the environment and every step taken to reduce our reliance on single-use plastics brings us closer to a cleaner, healthier ocean. While the problem of plastic pollution might seem overwhelming, each one of us has the power to make a difference. By making conscious choices in our daily lives, we can reduce our plastic footprint and contribute to the global effort to protect our oceans. Start by reducing your reliance on single-use plastics. Carry a reusable water bottle, bring your own bags to the grocery store, and choose products with minimal packaging. Simple swaps like these can make a big difference when adopted by millions. Support businesses and organizations committed to sustainability. Choose products made from recycled materials and support companies that prioritize responsible waste management practices. By voting with our wallets, we can drive demand for more sustainable alternatives. Finally, spread the word. Talk to your friends and family about the problem of plastic pollution and the importance of reducing our plastic consumption. By raising awareness and inspiring others to take action, we can create a ripple effect of positive change. Remember, the fight against plastic pollution is not about achieving perfection, but about making progress. Every small step we take, every plastic bottle we refuse, every piece of trash we pick up, brings us closer to a cleaner, healthier planet for ourselves and future generations.